Superstar. Second fly with an F3 airplane and the Radio Master. Let's see. ¿Listo? Ok.
Tren arriba.
Today we have a very nice weather. And the Superstar, as always, is going on rails. And of course with the Dual Sky, but power system, we have plenty of power. We perform a stall turn now. Very smooth. Now, half Cuban 8. This is not like the epilogue, but you can feel... I mean, I don't feel anything weird at all. So relaxing to fly this airplane. With this power? My god. Hago otra, ¿vale? Now, a little bit faster. We'll perform some maneuvers now to see how it feels, the transmitter. Go now to 45 degrees, half roll, line. Again, half roll. Very smooth. It's incredible, this Superstar with the electric motor, how... Let's perform a 4-point roll. One, two, three, four. This is just the second flight with this transmitter, so we need to make some adjustments, but I really like the first impressions. Voy a poner el landing gear ahora. Una pasadita con el landing.
Tren abajo.
Ole. So welcome again to our channel. Today we have a different video. We are trying the TX16S from Radio Master, one of the most popular transmitters in aeromodeling and in the drones. We are testing it, and maybe it's so popular because it's a very economic option. It's super competitive. It costs us around 140 euros because it has the whole sensors. So this is the upgraded version. And yeah, it's 140 euros. The receiver is from FR Sky, which is around 40 euros. And we are using also the LiPo battery sensor to see the voltage of each cell. And it was like 20 euros. We bought this radio like 2 or 3 months ago. And we tested it with our gliders. And we were super happy with everything in general. So before testing it in one of our main F3As, we decided to use the Superstar to make the first trials with an aerobatic airplane and see how it feels in hands, and also the software, the OpenTX, how difficult it is to program an F3A airplane and put mixes or adjust everything. And well, this is the first day. We just finished the third flight with it. And of course, it's difficult to judge because we are not performing like the P21 or the F21, but at least the first feeling is very nice. The first impressions are very good. So I don't feel that the radio is that cheap. I mean, you can compare, and maybe later we will make a video comparing it with the 18SZ from Futaba, because it's more or less the same shape of the radio. But I saw some videos saying that this is super bad quality, but for this price, I think that it's a very nice radio. And all the functionalities that you have, all the OpenTX features, it's something amazing. So I will try to make some videos showing you how it is for F3A, for aerobatics, how easy or not to program is, and all the functionalities. Apart from that, apart from the price for sure, we are trying it to see how this stabilizer mode works. This receiver, for less than 40 euros, has incorporated a stabilizer mode. So has the auto level, but also like a wind correction. So if you are going through a bump in the air, it corrects the position in principle. So this is something that would change completely the F3A. So we wanted to try at least the cheapest option, which is this this system that goes with less than 200 euros, you have everything. But yeah, imagine with a more expensive radio. But we want to see if there is a difference in F3A. So today I think that we will not be able to see really the difference compared with Futaba, but this will be like the first impressions testing it and showing you one of the main functionalities that we have installed. So remember that this is a radio of less than 200 euros. We have the quality of the signal, the minimum, the battery, the receiver battery, the battery of the transmitter. And this is a sensor for less than 20 euros that controls every single cell of the motor battery. Apart from that, the OpenTX maybe is not as intuitive as Futaba, JR, or any other kind of systems, but allows you to make whatever you want. So, I mean, I can put like a function that tells me when these batteries, the difference between the highest and the lowest is more than X. So whatever you want, you can adjust all the main screen. This is what I wanted, but I can select or put this whatever I want. Apart from that, look, what I have is like a motor cut, all the mixes I want. And here are the modes. So how it works is, this is normal mode. This is like a normal receiver with any kind of a stabilizer. The mode 2 is a completely auto level. So if we, no, the aileron, if we tilt the airplane, you will see that the aileron self-corrects the position to try to put it the airplane in auto level, and the same for the elevator. It's like, if I put here, then it goes back to level, the auto level. And then we have this one is more difficult to see, but it's just correcting the moment the airplane is moving. So again, as I said, for gliders, imagine for less than 30 euros you have altimeters, varios, and GPSs for less than the price of the GPS sensor of Futaba. So I think that it's worth to try it. Maybe people that is already using radios of more than 2,000 euros will not consider this interesting, but I think that for people that really wants to enter in the hobby and see if this radio is capable of be used for F3A or for aerobatics, maybe this series of videos testing it will be interesting. So yeah, let's try it.